Hey everyone, this is Barakat Kindo. This is the first of a series of videos on R programming language for data science and statistical analysis. And in this video, we are going to install R on a Windows machine. R software is a programming language used for statistical computing, data visualization, scientific report writing, among other things. It's an open source software. That is, it's freely available for anyone to use. And they have distributions for Windows operating system, Mac operating system, as well as Linux and Unix operating systems. R has a very rich collection of packages or modules, you could call them, for many statistical analysis methodologies, such as linear regression, nonlinear regression, clustering algorithms, classification algorithms, generalized linear models, such as, you know, logistic regression, the gamma regression. It's also another, it's got a very rich data manipulation library. One of them is called dplyr. It also has really, really beautiful graphics package called ggplot. And R is a premier choice for researchers and statisticians for dissemination of their new work on statistical methodologies. I have mentioned already that R is a free software. In this video, we will learn how to install R on a Windows computer. We will also install an open source edition of RStudio, a coding environment or a powerful integrated development environment for R and Python. Obviously, for you to first install R, you need to download R. And R is hosted on a network of servers around the world that are called the CRAN, C-R-A-N, the Comprehensive R Archive Network. And this URL, this link, automatically determines which CRAN server or CRAN mirror is nearest to you. So you can download R and install it. I'm gonna go to that link. And when I go to that cloud.r-project.org, I will have an option to install R for the operating system that I choose. And for me, that's Windows. The base distribution of R is what you want to install for the first time. I'll click on base. The current version that's listed out there now is R4.0.5 for Windows. I click on that and the download starts. Once the download completes, you go ahead and double click on the downloaded executable file. I'll double click on that and the installation starts. Simply choose the default options. English is fine. I'm gonna click next, install, next, choose the default options, next, next. That will start the installation of R on your computer. And now I'm going to install RStudio. The link for downloading RStudio, which is the integrated development environment for R, is this one. RStudio download link is right here. And you have options to install RStudio for several operating systems. When I go to that, you will have the download start. Once the download completes, double click on the application executable file. Again, I am going to select the default option. Click next, next, install. Patiently wait while the installation progresses and completes. Finish. Okay, we have installed R and RStudio. Now I'm going to start RStudio. Click on RStudio, a new programs list. And this is what you will see when you first open RStudio. Let me make the zoom. Let me zoom in view. To start writing R scripts, you go to file and new file and click on R script. Once I do that, there's tabs on the right you may not see or you might see when you open it. For me, I had pushed it all the way to the right so I can see the console, and which is the console is what you have at the bottom here. And then on the top right, you will have a list of variables and objects that you have created when you start writing your code. And on the bottom right here, plots that you create will be displayed here, and help documents will be displayed there as well. All right, so we will write simple program to multiply a vector by a constant. So let's create a vector named x. An R for you to do that, that's the way to do it, would be x equals, I can use the equal sign, or I can use the x less than dash to assign a value to the variable x. I want the code to be displayed better, so let me zoom in. And to create a vector of values, I'm going to use the C function, C command, C 1 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma negative 10. Just taking numbers, and to execute what you wrote, that script, into the console, you press Control Enter on Windows. So you will see it right here, already executed. And on the top right, you will see that you have an object called X. It's a numeric vector of 5 entries. All right, I'm gonna multiply X by a constant, let's say 10. And X times 10, highlight it, Control Enter. You know, 1 times 10 is 10, 1 times 10 is 10, 2 times 10 is 20, 3 times 10 is 30, and negative 10 times 10 is negative 100. Let me random generate uniform random numbers, 100 values of uniformly distributed random numbers. That's, let's say that is y. And then I can just plot y. Sometimes you can actually just type what you want in the console directly, and it will get executed right away. And that's the plot, you know, uniformly random numbers between 0 and 1. Okay, that's the end of our video here. So we've installed R and RStudio and went beyond that and wrote a few lines of code and displayed some plots. So this is just to get you started and how you use R by downloading it on your computer. Thank you.